Winnipeg, Canada, Grant began his career in commercial art, where he supervised the production of more than 300 television and 1,000 radio commercials. Grant now works full-time painting and teaching watercolor, and his paintings have won several awards and have been featured at local and international levels. His subjects range from buildings and boats to figures and portraits, and he is known for his fresh, loose style. Look for Grant's art instruction books on watercolor and drawing at northlightshop.com or visit his website at grantfuller.ca. In this workshop, Grant shares techniques for creating all aspects of the sea, including waves, ripples, reflections, wet sand, and more, so that you can create inspiring seascapes of your own.
Now, take the round brush. A little more cobalt blue, just a touch of burnt sienna in there so that it doesn't come off too blue. Cut just underneath that white. Clean the brush quickly and just touch the edge of that wash that you put down on the bottom. The idea is to get a soft edge at the bottom. We'll do the same with the other two. It's a little easier to see as I get larger. Cut underneath. And quickly, while that wash is wet, see if you can get back with a clean brush. Just touch that edge. It'll get smaller as it goes away from us. We'll do the same here. This wave isn't going to be as tall. It's already fallen, so I won't have to have quite the amount of curve. And then just break it in a few places here. But still, I want to soften this edge. Try to give the illusion that those waves are curling over. A bit of cobalt blue might look better in this shadow of white foam. This is actually a good stroke here to learn. I want some hard edges and some soft edges on this because the foam breaks into spray. So I clean the brush. Shake it out a little bit, just so it's damp, and just touch parts of that wash so that it softens some of the edges, not all of them. Now, I just want to go back in under here with a little bit more paint. So mix up a slightly darker green with that raw sienna and phthalo blue. Not too dark. See if I can just poke it under there to hopefully give me a bit of a curve. Clean the brush and soften this edge. The idea being here that it begins to look like it's curling up You're getting a shadow under here from the foam that's falling over the top, and then it's falling forward this way and creating this splash at the bottom.